screen.
China had the top four men in the world. Number two, Fan Zhendong, missed out on selection. The Kaniwa of Japan, Jun Mizutani and Maharu Yoshimura, the lineup, and they will be hoping to spring the upset.
Crowd is shaken, and the players will now go back to their respective corner. An opportunity for the last few words.
And here's the lineup for the gold medal match. Best of five series, opening with two singles.
Japan to serve. Zero.
I think you're absolutely right when you say that Koki Niwa, the pressure's not on him. If I was the coach, the Japanese coach, Kurashima, then I'd be saying, go out there, go for your shots, be positive, enjoy yourself. And who knows? But again, I did say a few days ago that in my time in table tennis, around table tennis, I picked three legends, and this gentleman's one of them. I just think he's an absolutely fantastic player. Complete in every department. They're coming across the table to return with his backhand from the forehand side. Marlon was waiting for the ball, the counter top spin, point to China. Good service there, Marlon thought there was backspin, he came under the ball to lift it. And of course, the ball pops up, a little bit of top spin on the ball, there it is. Ooh, right on the white line. Excellent backspin by Koki Niwa.
Two, opening match of the men's team gold medal match, the final between Japan and China.
Again, coming across the table to return with the backhand. It's a technique that's been developed by the top players in the world over recent years. Normally they'd return with the forehand. The new technique is to come across, return with the backhand. Excellent touch there by both players initially. It's so skillful to have the delicate touch shots and then explode with power.
He's holding his own here, Niwa.
Going for shots, he's playing positive. Excellent start by the 21-year-old.
The champ going up for Marlon.
Into it, but just slightly mistimed it. The ball caught the leading edge of the bat and flew off. A lot of support here for China. Of course, if you wanted to watch China win a gold medal 6 months before the games, then this final was a fair bet to buy your ticket for.
He's opened up a handy lead here, Marlon. 4-8.
slow motion, this will look quick. Yeah, it's point good. It's hit the edge, and you can see it come upwards, which is a clear indication it's hit the edge of the table.
Getting the top of the net, trying Ma Long's rhythm. Still 4 points the lead for Ma Long. Play from Ma Long. Arrives at game points in this opening game against Poki Niwa. And Ma Long clinches the opening game, 11 points to 6.
Came across to play the backhand, but it was even wider than he thought, so he had to readjust, play a forehand, and of course got himself in a little bit of a tangle, lost the point.
Let 1-0.
The team events the matches best of 5 games, like the singles, which is best of 7.
Clever serving from the moment where he's seen Poki Niwa go across to receive with his backhand from the forehand side. So he's just served fast serve down the line.
1-2.
The right thing to do by Niwa, threw himself into that backhand topspin. He has to go for winners. He's got to play to win the point, because this gentleman on screen isn't going to give you any points. You've got to win them against him. Set off to go with the backhand from the forehand side, anticipating coming down the line. He steps back, plays a pretty good backhand topspin, threw it up in the air a little bit. It's a good backhand topspin from the forehand side of the table. You can get a lot more wrist into the shot with the backhand from that position. And you can actually get side spin. It's almost the natural movement of the wrist gives you a little bit of side spin. Players have christened it the banana shot.
You'd have to say a bit of luck going Poki Niwa's way, but he's making his luck. He hits the lead in this second game, 4-3. It's Niwa that comes out on top of that. He's really settled into this battle.
He'll feel good after this point. He's played it really well. He's taken the Olympic world champion on topspin to topspin. He leads 5-3. A little bit of good fortune. That's what he's got to hope for. Go for your shots. A little bit of luck, and who knows?
And then look at that, right back at him.
Backhand from the forehand side of the table and the return of serve. Fascinating, 10 years ago, very few players did that. Now all the top players use that particular technique. Got round, but he didn't lift. See him going round there. He's got to lift a little bit. Just catches the top of the net. There's the good look we were talking about.
Very calm out there, Niwa. Just seems to have that emotional level right for this massive match in his career. He's in a good position in this second game. Four points ahead of Marlon.
Spin rather than speed.
Stopping the run of points against him. And five, only 2 points from leveling this match.
Serving this sequence of two. Big point this for Niwa. If he loses this, Marlon has his two serves to come. And he could be looking at a recovery. And the serve drifted long, and that's exactly what Marlon does. He gets a chance, he's in with the strong topspin, relentless as we mentioned earlier, and he's now got his two serves to come.
Timeout has been called by Japan. Niwa having been in such a terrific position in this game. He led 9-4, and now it is back to 9-7. So a smart move from the coach there. Marlon leading one game to love, but it is Niwa leading in this second game. Second game, coming back from a 4-9 deficit.
He needs to try and get in with a strong topspin behind his serve. Oh, and he did, but what a counter topspin from Marlon. Liu Guliang's on his feet. Clenching his fist, punching the air.
Well, Niwa, you would think, could have done enough in that point to set it up, but an amazing response from Marlon. Game point. Excellent play from Marlon. Charging back in that second game. Playing so solid. What a way to start this third game. Top spin forehand, leading two games to love. Champions recovery in that previous game. Has he broken his heart?
Early signs are that could be the case. 2 points with his serve going down for Koki Niwa, and now Marlon with two serves to come. Of course, now that's 10 consecutive points. 9-4 down, 11-9, takes the first 3 points. So, you know, when the going gets tough, the tough get going, as they say.
That's got to feel a lot better for Niwa.
Did well, though. It was a great return of serve from Niwa. Then he used his feet, moved very quickly, got in with the forehand from the backhand side. A rocket out wide to Marlong's forehand.
To come up with something spectacular, Niwa, to win these points, and to sustain that is going to be very difficult.
Great backhand there from Niwa. Punched it, elbow, wrist, didn't just block it back, he actually hit it back. Loose wrist, pushing underneath the ball, imparting the backspin. Interesting again. Marlon's targeting the middle of the table and the backhand side of the table when he serves. Not serving quite as many into the forehand. So Niwa not getting that backhand in from the forehand side of the table, quite simply, because Marlon's not serving there.
Marlong really not allowing Niwa to get into this third game. Good aggression. 2-7.
Totally relaxed his arm there. A rocket backhand topspin on the diagonal. Perhaps a little bit late, but why not? Throw caution to the wind, go for your shots. There, didn't know whether he should be close to the table, he should drop away.
Niwa, what a rally, stays in it. Defensive blocks there to keep him in it. Again, some luck going his way.
That's a wonderful run. Look how far he's away from the table. He's just throwing the ball up into the sky, hoping for exactly that. But Marlong almost got it back. Watch. Oh, we just can't quite see. He's off screen. But he was very close to returning the edge ball.
Marlong only 3 points from victory here. But Niwa, he again gets the luck in that point, keeping himself in this match.
And Liu Guliang calls timeout. Again, very astute as always, Liu Guliang. Just 2 points on the run for Niwa, but in fairness, there were two edge balls.
Well, a good time to call a timeout because he knows his man is going to be feeling a little frustrated by the luck that's gone against him. That is how it stands. 2 games to love. Marlong leading and 8-5.
I think you thought, I'll try and do it again, but you don't win many points when you drop away from the table against Marlong, unless you get the edge ball. So there's Xu Xin, he's preparing for the next match, which I suspect will be only a few minutes away.
What a point from Niwa!
This time though it was the net cord that helped him. He's had two edges on the previous ones. This just caught the top of the net, which we'll see on the replay here. Swaps it back and he throws one up and he hits this one. There it goes, off the net cord. Throwing the kitchen sink at that one. Topspin to topspin. Yu Guoyang's on his feet and four match points.
And there it is, Ma Long putting the first point on the board for China. Taking this match. Players warming up for the second match in the overall gold medal match.
In great form, bronze medal in the singles, unbeaten in the team event, five wins out of five. He opens up with that reverse backhand topspin. There'll be more of those to come. And there he goes again, turns the background, uses the backhand side, even though he's got the penhold grip. And of course, he'll know that Yu Guoyang chosen him to go up first against Mizutani. This is the one that Japan have to win. If they're going to win a match, this would be their number one possibility. Their number one player, unbeaten, bronze medalist. And that's why he was bronze medalist. He's played some great shots. That backhand down the line was absolutely top draw.
From the table, really unwinding on those.
Yeah, Mizutani matched him for power there. Mizutani's really having a great tournament, hitting the ball harder than I've ever seen him, just staying that little bit closer. Shujin is so strong with topspin against topspin, but Mizutani came out on top.
So quick around the table, onto that, and again the pace.
It's interesting tactically, when you play somebody who's so good with the forehand, often the tactic is to play into the forehand and get out wide and then pin them down the backhand and make them play backhands from the backhand side. Mizutani's already done that. He's gone out wide to Shushin's forehand several times. Very good tactics. What he was trying to do there, he was trying to play, albeit with a little bit more spin and not quite so much speed, but he was trying to get out wide for Shushin's forehand. Topspin from Shushin, didn't make contact with the ball.
Oh, that is brilliant. He was originally a right-hander, and his parents thought it would be an advantage to change him to play left-handed when he was very young. Thought it would provide him with an advantage over opponents.
On it was spot on down the line, get out wide to his forehand.
It's had a good year, won three ITTF world titles in 2016. Mizutani.
Amazing, there's some very delicate, soft shots. Previous point, the ball was going like a rocket. It's this ability to have a soft hand, delicate touch, and then suddenly explode into powerful, strong topspins. Maybe just a fraction too aggressive there. A little bit more control, but he's clearly got himself in the frame of mind where he's going to go for his shots. He's going to play strong top spins when he gets the chance.
Point for point here.
Just heading back and forth a little bit then on the backhand top spin. There, you can see the reverse backhand. He's shadow playing what he thinks he should have done there. So of course every 6 points the players are allowed to towel down. I thought then perhaps we had a timeout, one of them was, but not allowed to use the towel. Not every point, every 6 points.
This is a very tense battle in the opening game. See who can gain the upper hand.
Oh man, there's a corner. This really is a tight game. Sometimes you can be 7-6 up, but you know you're on top, you know you're stronger in different departments, and you feel it's just a matter of time. But this is definitely not one of those cases. These two are very, very close to each other at the moment. Coming up for the Japanese player.
Great placement down the line.
Shushin there, if you watch, pushes deep and then he's stepping around the backhand. Plays forehand, and of course Mizutani, perfect response, just comes straight down the line. More difficult to play down the line because the target's a little bit smaller.
Well, this is fascinating, just to see who will come up trumps in this first game. Point for point, and it's Japan with the slender lead, 1 point yet again.
Yep, best serve there from Shushin, twisted long. Mizutani was in straight away. Yuguyan looking on there, a little bit concerned. He knows Mizutani's in fine form and playing really positive table tennis. return. Second bounce was on the table, forcing Shuxin to play over the table. Tactics perfect, and we do have a timeout. No, we don't. Of course, it's 18 points, a further 6 points have progressed. And the guy's just using the towel.
Game points for Mizutani. Two opportunities to seal this opening game.
Shuxin played the first strong clocks, but Mizutani backed away from the table. It's not the tactics that are going to win him the game and the match. He knows that. He's made a really determined effort to stay close to the table, play strong on both wings. And he still has one game point left.
Gee, that's a good return from Shuxin. All level at 10 points all.
The margin between winning and losing, a couple of millimetres there, that backhand topspin down the line from Mizutani missed, but as you absolutely were right, that was a very positive return from Shuxin. He now has the serve. First player to win two clear points. Goal! Disappointed with that one, Shuxin. The return was slightly high. Came in and flicked through the back of the ball, as we see here, caught the top of the net. The net player flicks it off the end of the table.
For the third time, Mizutani has a game point. And this time he gets it. Spectacularly takes the opening game, 12-10. Mizutani taking the first game in the second match of the gold medal match. And he started the second in style.
The only thing there for China was that Zhuxian didn't read the spin. He came underneath the ball, he lifted, and of course there was no backspin to lift. The ball popped up and it was dispatched accordingly by Mizutani.
Mizutani is going to be full of confidence after clinching the opening game.
Powerful topspin from Zhuxin, probably his trademark shot there, the forehand topspin from the backhand side of the table. Mizutani's been very clever tactically in preventing him playing that particular shot by going wide to his forehand. Ball was low there for Shuxin, and he actually made contact. The ball was probably same height as the table, so he had to lift it to get it over the net. He didn't lift sufficiently. It's actually below table height, that one. A little bit soft on the return, Shuxin. I think he's feeling the pressure here.
Certainly looks like it. Mizutani just the opposite. Lots of positive body language from him.
Applauding Mizutani. Between them, they've certainly got the tactics right here. and the manner in which Mizutani is playing, not afraid to have a go, topspin against topspin there. Mizutani not backing off. He had a weakness previously, he used to back off a little bit, allow his opponent to dominate here. He's holding his ground a lot more, slugging it out with Zhu Jin.
Not missed too many. With the high level of aggression that he's been playing with.
Zhuzhen there just spinning the ball a bit more, not quite as fast as the previous point. Slowed it down, heavy topspin.
Points giving Zhu Jin a bit more hope in this second game. Mizutani just coming off the boil a little bit.
Three consecutive points for Zhu Jin, and there he used the reverse backhand really well. He used the backhand side of his racket, pushed up the ball. And the lead now for Mizutani down to 1 point.
Job into the body. And what a comeback here from Zhu Jin. Drawing level at 5-all. What was a hemorrhage of points against him. After losing five in a row, coming up with that to level at 6-all. After having taken the first game.
Zhu Jin didn't know whether to play over the table, let it come long. And then he has to flip over the table. And Mizutani, as we saw in the replay, there, in with that forehand topspin down the line. Close one to call this, 7-all.
such an important point for Mizutani.
Don't drop too long. Liu Guliang's on his feet, time out. So clearly this isn't anything to do with momentum, because there's no momentum in Xu Xin's favour at the moment. He clearly wants to have a talk to him about the tactics, how he's got to get in with that first strong topspin.
Interesting time to call this, but perhaps it's because Mizutani was able to seal that opening game in a tight point-for-point type situation.
To be honest, it's a reflection that Liu Guliang knows that this is in doubt, because why else would he call the timeout? There's no momentum. He just wants to have a word with his player, reinforce the importance of getting in with that first strong touch, and how he constructs the point so he can dominate the rally.
Returning from the timeout.
2-7-8.
Very tight stages of the second game. Mizutani of Japan having taken the first. And now with a 1-point advantage in the second.
Read the spin, the placement was exceptional, an outright winner on the return of serve. But again, Xu Xin going round the backhand to play his forehand.
Mizutani, 2 points from taking this game.
Return of serve sets up the point for Xu Xin. And of course, it will be Xu Xin who has the serves at the very end of this game. Big point coming up now.
Oh, what a response from Xu Xin.
These players play. And this catches the edge of the table. That's how close it is. You can see there how thick edge, but it still caught the edge of the table. Going for it wide, he acknowledges his good fortune. A really pitsy play.
And the finest of margins.
Come on, Mizutani.
Seeing us tied up at 9 apiece.
Served well, got round, got in with the strong forehand topspin, forced Xu Xin away from the table. And we now have the game point for a 2-0 lead for Japan.
That is terrific play from Mizutani. 11-9, he clinches the second game. 2 games to love, leading. Really held his nerve in the closing stages of that second game. Playing aggressively, a lot of self-belief. Here's the celebration, going to a 2 games to love lead.
Hiroshima, Japanese coach, delighted. Yes, indeed, is Mizutani, as you can see on the screen. now questions will be asked on Xu Xin. 2-0 down.
Mizutani, against the love, he leads for Japan. The Xu Xin of China. Critical for Xu Xin to get away to a good start in this third game, which is the best of five games. The edge going to Xu Xin. Hasn't had a lot of luck in this match. It's gone against him. But this time he gets it.
Two reverse backhand topspins that have won in the first 2 points. Izutani with the two serves now.
Super defense from Xu Xin, way back from the table.
For the spin. This time, good fortune favouring Xu Xin. He was at full stretch there. And somehow managed to get his bat on the ball, and then good fortune stepped in. Just tripled over the net. How does he get to that? I think he's almost diving for his goalkeeper going to save a penalty. But then a little bit of good fortune steps in, and he's now 5-love up.
Well, the luck definitely going his way. Coming down after 6 points, and all 6 points going. Xu Xin, quite a turnaround in this third game.
Block six. Block six.
Two reverse backhand topspins. The first one was good. The second one a little bit too hard. Gets the ball off the end of the table. Izutani opens his account in this third game. 1-6. Great push from Izutani. Took it quite early. High ball list underneath the ball. Got some pace on the ball as well. But I think you see a push going as fast as that one. Took Xu Xin by surprise. Off a little bit, more spin. And there we have the Chinese women's team down supporting the men.
7-2 at play.
At the beginning of the point. Xu Xin then launches into his trademark shot, the forehand topspin from the backhand side, overhits it. Top edge of the racket, just slightly mistimed it. like it's a terrible miss when the ball flies off, but it's just a fraction of a second out in the timing. The ball hits the top of the racket.
A very different game, this one. The other two were very close, point for point. Xuxin, now with a big lead, 6 points his advantage, 9-3. Setting up game points for Xuxin to get one game back. Xuxin taking the third game, 11 points to 3. Japan's Jun Mizutani leading 2-1.
Quite as strong as he did in the first two games, but I'm sure Yoshiki Hiroshima, the coach, will be advising him accordingly. And the player's back.
Movement on that ball.
It's a blow to Xuxin to lose a point like that, because that's what is his best, topspin to topspin. And then your opponent wins the point.
One all.
Xuxin coming across, returning with the reverse backhand topspin from the forehand side of the table there. Very skillful.
Brilliant.
Topspin on the diagonal, the backhand, then he steps round. Xuxin waiting out here for it to come down the diagonal. Mizutani whips it down the line. Great tactical play.
In terms of that third game, Mizutani just seemed to have a little lapse. He's been brilliant at many stages throughout this match.
Even though he lost the point there, I still felt he was trying to be positive. He was going for the backhand down the line. In the third game, I just thought he held back a little bit and played by his very high standards, just a fraction negative. That's perfect. That's what he has to do. He's got to serve, try and be strong behind the service, keep the pressure on Xuxin. Psychologically here, if Mizutani can pull off this win, it would be remarkable. But then Xuxin will have to go into the doubles with a defeat on his mind, which may just unsettle the Chinese doubles pair. So here we are talking about China being almost unbeatable, and Japan now find themselves in a very healthy situation.
So much pressure on Xuxin with the immense responsibility of playing this singles. Didn't play in the singles event here at the Olympics. started the tournament in this team event. And lifting, coming up with the goods in that point.
Great slow motion there. Forehand topspin, good footwork to get round the backhand. And a very strong, powerful forehand topspin down the line. Fortune for Xu Xin. Backhand, it's been push. Just caught the top of the net, tripled over.
Massive points right here.
For mental toughness here. I know the Chinese are tough, they prove it time and time again.
Being able to produce those sorts of shots in the tight situations under incredible pressure. 4-5.
Shifted to Xu Xin. Maybe we're going to have a timeout called. Yes. Kurashima wants to keep that for later in the match. Of course, Xu Xin wins, then we go into the fifth and final game. That really will be pressure for both players. A lot of pressure now. He knows he was a little bit fortunate, but it's about time he'll be thinking that he got a bit of luck. I suspect overall it's been evenly distributed throughout this match. Total commitment from Mizutani, and again, good tactics from the Japanese player. But that was the best shot of this match so far. He had the whole table to go for it. And look at the side spin. He was taking that ball out even wider than Mizutani's forehand, but Mizutani didn't even bother to try. He was hoping to make a winner on that return. Wasn't to be. 7-5, China lead.
Xu Xin holding up under pressure here. Shrug of the shoulders from Mizutani, trying to loosen up a little bit.
In with that rocket forehand topspin down the line.
And he's really responded in this situation, coming up with some of his best play. back in this fourth game.
Good backhand. Came right over to the forehand side to play that backhand. Just gives himself a slight lifeline here. But he's 3 points adrift. Shushin with his final serve in this sequence of two.
He's going after it.
Pressure mounts a little bit on Shushin. 9-5, he was up, now it's 9-7. And Mizutani now with the two serves. A lot of time to take 2 points with the serves. Well, a lot of risk going into that shot.
Great composure from Shushin, arriving at game points. An extraordinary effort from Shushin, taking the fourth game, 11-7. Drawing level at two games all. We will go into a decider. Big reaction from Shushin after winning that opening point of the fifth and deciding game. Needs to keep the momentum of having won the last two games to level this match.
Situation. He constructed the rally so that Mizutani was away from the table. Just look how far he's away. There's that backhand topspin. Big point psychologically keeps him in his fifth and final game in the second match.
A rock defense from Mizutani early in that rally. Shushin able to put it away.
What Mizutani mustn't think is he won that previous point from away from the table, and it was wonderful to see. But for every 5 points like that, he's only going to win one out of the five. He can't rely on that as a tactic. He has to get in from close to the table. Took the ball early, puts Shushin under a little bit of pressure. The ball's back on Shushin. He mistimed the reverse backhand, hit the edge of the bat, and look at that scoreboard. 2-2 in games, 2-2 in points. Couldn't be closer.
Shushin stay in that point.
Interesting there, if you see the replay, Shushin gambled. He ran round, watch him. He runs round his backhand. Look, there he goes. And Mizutani put it there. If Mizutani had whipped that one down the line like he has been doing, he would have won the point on Julien. You think he's playing in the match?
3-2.
It means so much. Well, it means it's the Olympic final. It means everything. Liu Guliang there. Olympic champion himself, world champion himself. Players will change ends when the first player makes 5 points. Xu Xin will be hoping that it's at 5-2. Be a big psychological boost for him to change ends with a 3-point lead. Mizutani just needs to get a couple more points in this first half of the deciding game.
Xuxin, each point building pressure on Mizutani. Timeout call at 5-2 to Xuxin, deciding game.
5-2, change of ends, timeout. I do think it's a good call because the momentum definitely with Xuxin. So a chance just to regroup, take a 1 minute break. Try and give him the advice he requires. I think he knows what he has to do, but he's up again. Xuxin's just a great player.
Not know what you have to do, but sustaining what he's had to do to win the points, that effort you can see is telling the strain of it. And certainly Mizutani just looking a little at a loss after those last 2 points. Look skyward.
But it was interesting to see Liu Guliang's reaction to one of those points. He knows this is a pressure point in this final. He knows if Xuxin loses, then they go on in the doubles with Xuxin thinking, I've just lost my singles. So even though 5-2 up, it really is a pivotal moment in this final.
What an encounter this is. The result, no means a done deal. Mizutani trailing 2-5, deciding game.
Long, Xuxin though, pounced on it, and what a strong forehand topspin return of serve.
The body language from Mizutani, looking up, having a talk to himself, looking nearly as confident. 4-point advantage to Xuxin.
What he has to do, of course, is just focus everything on the next point, not think about the fact that was 2-0 up. Good return, kept it tight. Xuxin launched himself into it, but it was tight enough to force the error. He's got his two serves to come after this point. A 6-4 down, it wins his two up with service. He's right back in it, but there's a few ifs in that statement. Turns. Are we about to see another twist and turn? It looked like Mizutani was going to win 2-0 up. Xuxin wins the next two, takes a lead. Mizutani's coming back at him. Tremendous stuff. Return of serve from Xuxin, the long push. I was thinking the short push or a flick. Probably why I wasn't any good.
Courageous shot, great depth. That reaction from Mizutani saying it all. 4-7.
Oh, topspin. The reverse backhand topspin from Shushin, but then Mizutani stepped round, played a counter forehand topspin. There's the reverse. And there's the counter topspin. Well done, Mizutani. Keeping his focus. Trying to play as positive as he can. This can still be won by Mizutani. It's going to be tough. He looks a little bit stressed. You don't see that very often. Yu Guliang is back on his feet. He's up and down like a jack-in-the-box in that corner.
Brave backhand. Shushin keeping his composure. Leads 8-5, deciding game.
Mizutani. Mizutani now with two serves to come. What a time to take 2 points with your serves. It would level this deciding game at 8 points each. Can he do it? First serve coming up. Spun the ball two or three times and then launches the rocket, comes more forward with the action through the ball. There he spins up, and it kicks.
Nine, six, China leading. Good placement into the body of Shushin.
The problem now for Mizutani as he has to return the Shushin service. Interesting to see the serves that Shushin comes out with. He'll, I think, be looking to get in with a strong topspin behind the serve. I'll be surprised to see a long, fast serve, but who knows? Oh, what a well-placed topspin by Shushin into the backhand. Much to the delight of Yu Guliang there in the corner. Just look at him.
Movement on that bench. Thrilled to see their man arrive at match points. 10-7. He saves one.
Mizutani, of course, now has his serves to come. He needs to be brave, he needs to be positive behind the serve.
All about what he can deliver right here, Jun Mizutani. Down to match points.
There's a weak return of service, and you're looking to say that when a player's world class as Xu Xin is, but look, it popped up, it was mid-table, and it was dispatched into his body.
So one match point remaining for Xu Xin.
Look at that, twists and turns. He held his ground, he stayed close to the table. He played positive table tennis and he's reaped the reward.
Showing the belief out here, Mizutani. Staving off match points. Staying alive in this match. What you sense is a pivotal match in this final. Two games all, 10-all.
Spinny topspin. How clever was that from Mizutani? Ball dropped over the side of the table. He spun up the back of the ball, brushed it, the ball was fizzing with topspin.
Well, after saving match points against him, Jun Mizutani arrives at a match point of his own. He's gone down on his knees. Celebration for Jun Mizutani, pulling off a huge upset here. 10 times in the end of that fifth game. He takes it 12-10 in the decider.
You don't often see that. China leading 10-7, three match points. And full credit to Jun Mizutani. There he is on screen. Mental toughness of the highest order. He was aggressive, controlled aggression, and he wins the fifth game. Just flicking off the end of the table. This time, perfect execution of the flick. And Xu Xin straight through the back of the ball. Read the spin well.
Both combinations with a left-right partnership, which I guess will negate each other a little bit. Really getting the Chinese on the stretch. Great placement.
Good top spin down the middle of the table from Xu Xin. I think the left-handed, right-handed combination tends to be the one that countries are looking to develop. It just creates a little bit more space down the middle of the table for players to get in with their forehands. As long as you get the footwork right, you move back to your backhand side of the table, it opens up the table for your partner's forehand more often than not. One backhand there from Yoshimura.
The start they've had here. So as the Japanese pair have done well on the world tour, of course the Chinese pair have won so many. Aggressive. Jika and Shishin won three doubles titles on the world tour this year alone.
So it's drifted long. Shishin pounced on the opportunity to make that forehand topspin. Very strong. Always tough when you're the one player who's not had a game, a match in the contest so far. Zhang Jik, of course, in the same situation. They're coming in cold.
Seven.
Oh my goodness, the backhand from Yoshimura, the forehand topspin off the bounds from Koki Niwa. Early he took the backhand topspin there, Yoshimura.
Such aggressive play, very flashy. Niwa and Yoshimura. They're up 4 points, 8-4 with the serve. Five points in a row they have won, now have game points. Oh, what an opening game for Yoshimura and Niwa, taking it for Japan 11-4. Japan with the upper hand, taking the opening game.
Smash down the line. Of course, the two Japanese players are just going out there. They're being positive. They're going for the shots. They'll be disappointed with that one. Shimura just pointing to his partner, basically saying, "You did the business. Then I let you down." That's the easy ball.
And aggressive, the Japanese combination really dominating in some of these rallies. Very positive mindset they have.
backspin. Jika just came up the back of the ball. And China now leads 3-2. Signal there from Zhang Jika. So Xu Xin knows what serve his partner would like. Out wide, played the angle well. He comes out wide to Kokiniwa's forehand. Just watches the ball go by.
Jika. And Xu Xin just getting on top now. They have a little run of momentum. Some bounce in their step.
And his coach encouraging his players. He'll be delighted with the situation at the moment. Shots that the two Japanese players have to go for. Chance their arm if it comes off. Again, he was looking to topspin on the return of serve. Kokiniwa changed his mind because it was an excellent serve. Second bounce was actually going to be on the table, so he had to recover play over the table. He couldn't quite adjust quickly enough. Games here, 11-4 for Japan in the first, and perhaps a similar score here.
Amazing how things can turn around so quickly. Start of a new game. China serving at 9-3, second game. Japan having taken the first.
Out wide.
Seven game points for China. They get one back. Strong backhand from Yoshimura.
Down shot. I might as well go for it. Just look at that. It shows he's got the talent.
From 10-3 back to 10-6. Zhang Jika to serve now. And there is the second game, 11-6 to China, levelling this doubles, the third of the matches at one game all, the overall match at one match all. One game all in this doubles match. China versus Japan. Third match of the team event, gold medal match. And quite astonishing the turnaround from the first game, which Japan won 11-4 in 5 minutes. Second game going to China 11-6 in the same time, just totally different.
It's amazing. It's a pair that got off to a good start that's dominated the game. In the first game, Japan got off to a flyer. China never really got back into it. And then the same happened in the next. It was actually 10-3 for China, and then Japan got a few points at the end. So I think the start of the game is so important for both pairs. One pair goes ahead, the other pair seem to tense up a little bit. Doubles, of course, is a little bit more unpredictable than singles. More shots than doubles. And of course, these pairs have won big tournaments, but this will mean more than winning any tournament, this doubles, because whoever wins this doubles puts their team in a great situation for the gold medal.
On the bench, jumping up and down.
I'm amazed he's got any adrenaline left. And that flip off the line from Xu Xin, hits the net cord, flicks it off the side of the table. Keep it quite low over the net as well. Just have a look at that again. Here it comes now. It's not as low as I thought, but it still had a lot of tops, but it was fizzing with spin. And he could be disappointed. His forehand from the backhand side is normally very reliable. Overhits that one. And the lead, 1 point, still anybody's game.
Very different game, this one. Much close up, no one running away with it. One game all, five all. Time they've been in the lead at that 6-5 point, now 7-5.
So it's there. Great from Xu Xin. So Mike Corkineal to play a strong topspin. He had a chance there. Just throwing the lifeline to China. 8-5 down would have been a serious advantage for Japan. 7-6. Again, there he is, low over the net, side spin. It was the side spin that won the point. Corkineal looking at his back, surprised that there was that much side spin on the ball. Yeah. top spin again. Jika would have been hoping to make the counter top spin. Stepped away from the table to give himself a little bit more time. Set it up. It was well executed by Jean-Jacques. There he comes. Trying, of course, will serve at the business end. Big point. Top spin, both coaches on the feet. Great rally.
Such tight situations out here. One game all, 9 points all. Look what they're coming up with.
Crucial moment. Arguably in the whole match, the overall match. A win here for Japan. They have to win two games, of course. This one, tightly in the balance. Forehand topspin from the backhand side, and well appreciated by Liu Guoliang.
All happening so quickly out here. Wonderful rally, bringing up game point for China.
Do you think he's pleased?
He'd be more pleased if his team can win this one. And they do. China taking the third game, 11 points to 9. It was a beauty. They lead 2-1. Start of the fourth game. China leading 2-1.
Japan, just sense now maybe the tide has turned. They needed to win that third game, we identified that. And he's absolutely right, he's the Japanese coach, on his feet, time out. You really sense the change in momentum.
And they had their opportunities in that second game. Quite get there, and now got to get over the disappointment of that, and also Chinese here just playing with a bit more confidence, having that third game in their pocket. 3-love in the fourth, 2-1, China leading, doubles and 3-love in the fourth.
Always good to win the first point after the timeout, psychologically. Looking to break the momentum, you win a point, so job done. Can they get a few more points now?
They do. 2 points on the trot after the timeout. Really, the way that can happen. and Zhang Zhikip and Xu Xin. They had a lovely flow happening in those opening points of this fourth game. The bubble was burst by the timeout. 3-all.
Great shot from Yoshimura, held his ground, played the forehand topspin. And that's four consecutive points now for Japan. They're definitely back in this fourth game. Constantly having to change the bat angle. Flip down the line. Sorry, the backhand topspin down the line rather than a flip. It's a good idea. Zhika had started to step round the backhand, but it misses. Tactics were good. Execution. It's a heavy backspin on the serve there from Xu Xin. Really came underneath the ball. Was fizzing with backspin. And China now back with a two-point lead.
And importantly, with that momentum off on their side.
Good push there by Yoshimura. Suddenly went long and deep. Not sure, he's just holding his back a little bit. He has had a history of back injury.
Certainly pulled up after that shot. Looked uncomfortable as he stood after that. And a timeout has been called.
Definitely in some pain. Zhang Zhikip. Good top spin, giving time to stretch his back a little bit, unleash that forehand top spin.
Doesn't seem to be having any problems with the movement. Concern would be that he has had major problems with the back. A fracture in a part of his spine in 2015.
Good use of the wrist from Zhang Zhikip. Got a little bit more topspin on the ball. The block not quite over the spin. So China now a useful three-point lead, and it's the second serve in this sequence for Xu Xin. And a flick off the end of the table from Yoshimura. It was a brave thing to do.
Time running out for the Japanese team. Must win this game to stay in it. 5-9. Match points for China. Zhang Zhikip and Xu Xin. That is it. A gentle celebration there, relieved to get through that one. Zhang Zhikip and Xu Xin winning that one 3-1, 11-5 in the fourth. So confirmation of that result, 3-1, 11-5 in the fourth, going China's way. This is the fourth match. China lead 2-1 in the overall match. Ma Long having won his opening singles against Koki Niwa of Japan. Shushin of China losing to Jun Mizutani of Japan. And then the doubles. China winning that one, but not without its dramas. So now we go into a fourth singles with Maharu Yoshimura of Japan taking on Ma Long. Yoshimura ranked 21 in the world and 23 years of age. And it will be a tough task for him against the world number one.
And the world number one is so strong in the team event. He actually was the youngest person to win a gold medal in team event, and he won that back in Bremen as a 16-year-old. He was a member of the Chinese team, which is an amazing performance. Here we are 10 years later. He's the number one player in the Chinese team. He's put together a run of some 30 matches now, undefeated. So statistically speaking, Olympic champion, world champion, with an impeccable record in team event. It doesn't get any tougher for Yoshimura than coming against Ma Long, but you just don't know what's going to happen. There's always surprises in sport, and that's what's so wonderful about the Olympics and sport itself. But this gentleman has a tough task in front of him.
Match four of the gold medal final of the team's event. Ma Long to serve. Also, Yoshimura has to deal with the disappointment of the doubles. He has just played and lost.
That's a fantastic shot, just steps around the backhand.
So smooth.
Just went like a bullet, didn't it? Down the middle of the table by the looks. He has this ability, even when he's leaning and he looks out of balance, he still plays with power. Look at that for return of service. Phenomenal.
Like so many great champions, he makes it look easy.
Yoshimura showing good attitude there, he's fighting for every point. Needs to be brave, needs to take a few chances. Just hope the luck goes his way slightly. That's been a little bit long. Yu Guliang, the Chinese coach, just looking a little bit more relaxed.
Just has such tremendous confidence in this man, being able to deliver. There were some very tight moments in the doubles.
Just missed time the service action there. I don't think the ball went. I think the ball was thrown up as he would have liked, maybe stuck in his hand a little bit. Oh my goodness, what a great flick. Textbook technique there, top of the bounce, elbow, wrist, through the back of the ball.
And Ma Long all over Yoshimura at the moment, 7-1. Not putting a foot wrong here, Ma Long. only conceding 1 point so far, game points. So there is the opening game. I'm not quite sure what happened there, but 11 points to one. Absolutely destroying his opponent, Marlo.
Wait for that again. What happens here?
Yoshimura double hit the service, and he just conceded the point.
11-1 opening game going to Marlo.
Be brave on the return of service, and then try and get in with that first backhand or forehand topspin. Chance your arm.
Yoshimura. Marlo tearing through the opening game. Only 4 minutes, 11 points to one. Second game. And the problem for Team Japan is, what do you tell Yoshimura? What can you do out here? Take a few more risks.
Service. I think the first thing you say to a player is, do your best. Just go out there, give it 100%. Tactically, try and get in with the strong shots, backhand or forehand. Positive, didn't quite work out, but the tactics were appropriate by Yoshimura. Good return of serve, and then Marlon in with the topspin, the Chinese bench on its feet, and this is just the start Marlo needed. Really stamping his authority in this fourth match.
That placement that has allowed him to relax a little more out there. Show us this great repertoire that he has, not feeling pressured by his opponent.
Topspin against topspin. Marlo coming out on top.
Oh.
Nakamura still fighting for every point, clenched fist.
Solid top spins from Ma Long. What a tournament he has had. Already has the gold medal in the singles. Working his way towards another one here. Eight two, very much in charge of the second game and the match.
Absolutely top-class player in Yoshimura.
Mistakes out there. It's by a game and 9-3.
Well done, Yoshimura. Good use of the feet. Get into position to play a strong forehand topspin. See the topspin now. Round he comes. The middle into the body of Ma Long. And Ma Long spins off the end of the table.
Six game points for Ma Long of China. Watching one of the greats of the game here. Brilliant play from Ma Long. Takes the second game 11-4. And goes to a 2-games-to-love lead. A brilliant performance so far from Ma Long. 11-1, 11-4. Leading 2-games-to-love, 1 game from the gold medal. Serving to start proceedings in the third game. He's taken the first 2 games in convincing fashion. If he can win this game, he will take China to the gold medal. Yoshimura looking to have something to say about that. Has to start this game very positively. Try and make some inroads.
Heavy batsman on the service. fast wrist pushing underneath the ball. Misread the speed on the ball. Clever play from Yoshimura. Chop block there with side spin from Marlon. Coming down on the ball. There it is.
Beautiful rhythm and so much power generated. 3-2. Extends his lead to 4-2. This gold medal match, it is the best of five, the overall match. So Yoshimura must win this game to stay in it, to keep Japan in the race for the gold. He's up against it, though, against the world's best. To love. We think he is in a commanding position to bring this one home for China. Japan have done well with Jun Mizutani taking the second match against Shushin. China winning the first with Ma Long defeating Koki Niwa, and then the doubles going to China. If they can win this, China take it. And that would rob us of what would have been a tantalizing fifth singles, fifth match in the singles. 4-2.
So Marlon just carrying on from where we left off. Japanese coach hoping to break the momentum. I don't think it's momentum, it's like a steam train coming at you here. Just so formidable is Marlon. And of course, as you mentioned, it would have been wonderful to see the fifth game. It's not all over yet, but the thought of Mizutani versus Zhang Jike at two games, at two matches each. And I think Mizutani would have been in there with a chance. He's unbeaten in the team event. He's won 6 out of 6. He got a bronze medal in the singles. Zhang Jike was holding his back a little bit. He's clearly got a few problems. So it would have been fascinating to see 2-2. The doubles, of course, was Japan's chance. In all fairness to Yoshimura, he's doing everything he can here, and a credit to him for his attitude. He's fighting for every point, but he really is up against one of the all-time greats. So a great effort by Japan. They've got a bronze medal in the individual, they've got a silver medal in the team event, and of course, 4 years' time, we go to Tokyo for the next Olympics. It'll be fascinating to see how this Japanese team has come on.
Just so solid, consistently brilliant. 2 games to love, 7-3, Ma Long leading. China 3 points from it. Much for the Japanese fans to cheer about right now. Superb top spins from Ma Long.
Even Liu Guoyang was relaxed there.
He knows that the team is in good hands here with Ma Long coming out here, taking the first two games convincingly. Now, 7 match points, 7 gold medal points. China. A clean sweep for China at the Olympic tournament. And what a brilliant performance from this man, the world number one, the gold medalist in the singles here. He went out there very calmly. Went about his business, played brilliantly to dispatch Haru Yoshimura. 11-1, 11-4, 11-4. And with that victory, China takes the gold medal, winning 3 matches to 1.
Bronze medalists, medaglia di bronze,
l'Allemagne,
Germany.
The bronze medals, medalists in the team event, Germany. They were the bronze medalists in London, this same team.
Timo Boll.
Timo Boll, also a silver medalist in Beijing.
Dmitry Ovcharov.
Dmitry Ovcharov, also a silver medalist in Beijing. Bastian Steger.
Great win against the Republic of Korea in the bronze medal match. And it's the veteran player, Timo Boll, who was involved in the doubles win and won his singles against Josie Hook. So two great performances by the 35-year-old senior member of the team, 6 times European champion. But this will mean as much to him as any of those titles, an Olympic medal.
Medaille d'argent.
Silver medalists.
Medaille de plata.
Le Japon.
Japan.
Japan.
What a great Olympic tournament they have had. Japan, silver medalists. Led by Jun Mizutani.
Koki Niwa.
Koki Niwa, only 21 years of age.
And Maharu Yoshimura.
Maharu Yoshimura, 23-year-old. A wonderful moment for them, taking the silver. They will be looking to Tokyo 2020.
A young team, ably led by Yuan Mizutani, unbeaten in the team event, bronze medal in the singles, and two youngsters to back him up. How will they do in Tokyo in 4 years' time? It's going to be very interesting to find out.
Gold medalists and Olympic champions!
Medalha de ouro e campeões olímpicos!
La République Populaire de Chine!
The People's Republic of China!
República Popular da China!
Here they are. Ma Long, his second consecutive team gold, won the singles gold here. Zhang Zhika, Xu Xin. Xu Xin making his Olympic debut here.
It's a pretty impressive lineup, isn't it? You start on the left with the current Olympic and world champion. You finish on the right with the former Olympic and world champion. And you put Zhu Xin in the middle, who is number three in the world at this point in time. That is a very, very good team. Arguably the best we've seen.
Ladies and gentlemen, the anthem of the People's Republic of China.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da República Popular da China.